Hello, everybody. Welcome back to the Music Writing, Ranking, and Reviewing Podcast, I like to call Music Meltdown, which this time we are on to 1985. Bit of a weird year in the 80s, I'd say. Doesn't really fit into most standard conventions or whatnot, so it'll be interesting to see what we have here. Any opening remarks about 85 here?
Again, very strong year. Love a lot of albums this year, and like the last year, and just a great year.
Nice. All righty, are you ready to kick things off with what you got here?
Oh yeah. I forgot I'm starting.
All good.
But yeah, I don't know, just some honorable mentions would be Eurythmics, Be Yourself Tonight, which was my which I enjoy. And what else do I have? Like I'm gonna shout out Misplaced Childhood by Marillion. So like this 80s prog band, and their vocalist just sounds like Peter Gabriel in Genesis. It's very cool. Prince, The Revolution with Around the World in a Day. Trying to think like there's like so many great albums that I could mention, like New Order. I enjoy Low Life quite a bit, and Fever Ra Rush, Power Windows, Sting, and I could just mention so many, but just missing one from my list is probably Kate Bush with Hounds of Love, and just a great album. I personally prefer probably the first side, actually, the popular one. Like the I do enjoy side two. Has some cool moments in side two, but side one's just Running Up That Hill, title track, The Big Sky, and Cloud Busting, and all so many awesome songs. But my actual list, starting with number five, which I don't think you're as big of a fan of this album, but it's Brothers in Arms by Dire Straits. And just a very solid album. One of the, if not the biggest 85 albums in sale, I'm not sure, but sort of this still has the Dire Straits sound, but more popular maybe. And I don't know, is Heartland Rock here good word term to use? But and yeah, I pretty much like every song. Obviously the side one has the singles, and side two is more deep cuts, but Right Across the River is one of those songs that I just love playing loud and feel it. It's just very cool. Yeah, was my number five. My number four, which could have been almost my three thirds, but I just have it number four now, but it's Boys and Girls by Bryan Ferry. So his solo album from the guy from Roxy Music. And just plenty of sophisticated pop greatness in this one. And Slave to Love is probably my favorite song. It was a single from this album. And just recently, I didn't even realize that Bryan Ferry did had a spot in Live Aid, and which is a great he did Slave to Love and Cellist Guy, the John Lennon cover. It's a great set. But yeah, this just lots of cool things about this, and I love some of the players that he uses. Like, yeah, there's like lots of my favorite session players, like Tony Levin and Marcus Miller on bass, and Omar Hakim on drums. It's Mark Knopfler. Pretty sure this also had has name that's skipping my mind from Pink Floyd, David Gilmour, and yeah, lots of great players and great songs. And number three is definitely maybe the noisiest album that you're gonna find on my list, but it's Psycho Candy by the Jesus and Mary Chain. And yes, I do sometimes struggle with noisy music, but I think this kind of has like that great blend of like almost like a 60s pop feel to it, but it's just underneath that very noisy guitar feedback and all the sounds they create. And Just Like Honey is my song of the year. I love listening to it. And yeah, it's a yeah, it's like some of these albums that I love, but not sure exactly how often do I listen to this, but it's definitely a cool album and still worthy of the placement on my list. Number two, I have The Cure with The Head on the Door, which is the first time that The Cure was on my actual list, and love this a lot. I saw The Cure live last year, and they played a few songs from this album, like In Between Days, Push, Close to Me, and Night Like This. And yeah, this is just plenty of The Cure greatness in this one, gothic type of stuff, and it's still very poppy, and love the synths, and it even has nice energy and goes very fast. It's like under 40 minutes, I would say. So could have been my number one, but my number one is Songs from the Big Chair by Tears for Fears. And yeah, this is just a banger after banger album, like perfectly crafted, I would say, and love every song on this basically, and I listen to it at any time. It has some of the you need some of these songs, in my opinion, if you make a 80s playlist kind of. And Head Over Heels is my favorite. I love listening to it, and I love Shout and The Working Hours. Everybody Wants to Rule the World is the biggest single. Love it, but honestly, it's not one of my top favorites from this album, but I still love it. And yeah, I love their voices, especially the Rowlands, and just a very, yeah, like I said, perfectly crafted album. So it's my number one. Yeah,
Nice.
that's my list.
That's an album. I want to love it more than I do. Like, I think that it's very good. I think that the majority of it is very strong, but just something about it, I can't get over the hump. It's kind of stuck at four, but it feels like it should be a four and a half, but it's just That gut feeling doesn't push it higher. Anyways, my honorable mentions, kind of one that I'm surprised that you didn't mention. I got Steve McQueen by Prefab Sprout. Pretty apex of Sophistopop. Really, the only issue I have with it is I'm not the biggest fan of Fair and Young, weirdly enough. I think that's a good song, but I think that every other song on the record blows it out of the water. So I don't know. Next up, I got Tim by The Replacements. Potentially one of the biggest drop-offs for me, but only because Let It Be is my favorite album ever. I still think Tim is excellent. It's just, it doesn't quite live up for me. So afterwards, I got Promise by Sade, probably one of the most equally matched follow-ups ever. It's just, I think 85 is a, it's not a stronger year. It's just the albums I have higher. I probably like a bit more than Promise. Then my final honorable mention is going to be Our Favorite Shop by the Style Council, just missing out. Going into my top five here, number five for me, one that you had, The Head on the Door by The Cure. Really them fully embracing pop music, but you still got the dark sort of moodiness of it, and Robert Smith just killing himself on here. Great, great stuff. Moving up from there, I got New Day Rising by Husker Du. Really just for me, a perfect punk record, just hard charging energy, super noisy. The guitar tones on this album are so good. I love them. I love them. They're just so in your face, so noisy. No, ah, so noisy. You'll hear me talk about noise later. You better expect it. Number three for me, I'm going to have Rain Dogs by Tom Waits. Talking about noise, let's start talking about craziness. This album is wacky. It's got this sort of weird, almost jazzy flair to it. You have Tom Waits' gravelly, sort of crazy vocal style out there and weird subject matters. And really, just all of the songs at their core are incredibly well made and well performed, despite how off kilter and sort of outside the box that they are. I love it a lot. My top two, both 5-star records. I love them a ton. Number two for me might be my pick for one of the more underrated albums just in general. Because a lot of people always consider this the worst album by this band. It's easily my favorite. I've got Meat Is Murder by The Smiths. I think this album is just incredible. It's kind of like their take on like a jam band scene because it's not quite as pop focused or as hook driven as other Smiths material. But Johnny Marr sounds incredible. The bass is going crazy. I love the drums across this record. I still think that Morrissey is writing very good tracks and his vocal work is sensational. It just isn't quite, you know. It's not exactly what you expect from the Smiths. It doesn't have that. It's not quite as jangly. It's not quite as pop forward, but I'd say it's almost sort of post-punk in a sense. I love it a lot. But my number one, pretty clearly, one of my favorite albums of all time, I got Psycho Candy by the Jesus and Mary Chain. An album that I am very surprised that you like as much as you do because it feels like the antithesis of Tavicore, but just how noisy, how abrasive, and just how crazy this record is. I can't get enough of the sound of it. It's so distorted, it's so messy, but it has such a great sort of intensity to it that you love. It's got this really dreamy, ethereal nature to it, but despite at their core, these being almost like 60s homage songs and how they're structured, being very short, sweet, simple pop numbers at their core, but they're surrounded by this monstrous, crazy noise. It's so cool. It has such an interesting quality to it. And it's a shame because they never really get back to this. Like, Automatic is closer, but on Darklands, you get like none of this crazy noise. And while I still love the Future Jesus and Mary Chain records, give me the noise. I want more noise. But yeah, love it a lot. 5 stars, my favorite album of 1985, Psycho Candy by the Jesus and Mary Chain.
Yeah, you're correct. Psycho Candy isn't really typical my style, but I don't know. I kind of like noisy guitars, but I usually if the vocals are noisy too, I might have problems. But I don't know.
It's no Steve Lukather tone. It's certainly that.
No.
That being said, any closing remarks for 85, or do we seem to have gotten our point across with these records?
No, I probably don't have anything like I guess I didn't really. Did I pick any metal? I'm not even sure. Did I say any metal?
think
Metal is
we
going
had.
strong still.
Was Power Slave last year or this year?
Oh, 84 it
All right.
was. I didn't mention any metal. Oh well, oh
Cool. You did
well.
mention Marillion, though, so we got the prog, just no metal.
Yeah,
Maybe?
even well, I don't know if Rush anymore Prague, but
Maybe like progressive pop, you could argue.
yeah,
Maybe not on
true.
Power Windows, though. That might be a stretch for that record. That being said,
Yeah.
really hope that you enjoyed the discussion. Push it list down below, and you all have a great time.